And now, cried Max, let the wild rumpus start. The wild thing is cried. No, please don't go. We'll eat you up, we love you so. And Max said, no. Where the wild things are. The night Max wore his wolf suit and made mischief of one kind. And another. His mother called him wild thing. Max said, I'll eat you up. I'll eat you up. I'll eat you up. So he was sent to bed without eating anything. That very night in Max's room, a forest grew and grew until his ceiling hung with vines in the wall. Sailed off through night and day. And in and out of weeks and almost over a year to where the wild things are. And when he came to the place where the wild things are, they roared their terrible roars and gnashed their terrible teeth. And rolled their terrible eyes and showed their terrible claws. You know, who are these bastards? Till Max said, be still. Wild things cried, no, please don't go. We'll eat you up, we love you so. And Max said, no. We'll eat you up, we love you so. We'll eat you up, we love you so. Now stop! Max said, and sent the wild things off to bed without their supper. And Max, the king of all wild things, was lonely and wanted to be where someone loved him best of all. Then, all around, from far away, across the world, he smelled good things to eat, and so gave up being king of where the wild things are. But the wild things cried, no, please don't go. We'll eat you up, we love you so. And Max said, no. The wild things roared their terrible roars and gnashed their terrible teeth and rolled their terrible eyes and showed the terrible claws. But Max stepped into his private boat and waved goodbye. And an ocean tumbled by with a private boat for Max and sailed off through night and day.